Morning, dear students. Now we see Standard 9th Science Unit 1 Measurement. What is measurement? Measurement is defined as the determination of the size or the magnitude of the quantity. What is measurement? Measurement is defined as the determination of the size or the magnitude of a quantity. It is the basis of all important scientific study. It plays an important role in our daily life. It answers the questions like how long, how heavy, and how fast. Now we see about the physical quantities. What is physical quantity? Quantity that can be measured or called physical quantity. Quantity that can be measured or called physical quantity. The physical quantity is classified into two types. One is fundamental quantity and the other one is derived quantities. Now we see about the fundamental quantities. What is fundamental quantity? Quantity which cannot be expressed in terms of any other physical quantities are called fundamental quantities. Length, mass, time, electric current, temperature, amount of substance, luminous intensity. These are some of the example for fundamental quantities. The next one is the derived quantities. Quantities which can be expressed in terms of fundamental quantities are called derived quantities. Area, volume, velocity, acceleration, angular velocity, angular acceleration, density, momentum, moment of interior, force, pressure, energy, impulse, surface, moment of force, electric charge, current, density, magnetic induction. These are the examples for derived quantities and their units are given. Now we see about the units. What is unit? It defined as a specific magnitude of a physical quantity that has been adopted by law or convention. A unit is standard quantity with which the unknown quantities are compared. For example, feet is the unit for measuring length. Now we see about the unit systems of earlier times. In earlier times, some systems are used that are CGS, FPS, and MKS. CGS that means centimeter, gram, and second. FPS means foot, pound, second. MKS means meter, kilogram, and second. At the end of the Second World War, there was a necessity to use worldwide system of measurement. So SI system, International System of Units, was developed and recommended by General Conference on Weight and Measure at Paris in 1960 for international usage. Now we will see about the SI systems of units. SI system of unit is the modernized and improved form of the previous system of units. It is accepted in almost all the countries. There are 7 fundamental units in the SI system of units, that is also known as base units: length, mass, time, amount, temperature, electric current, luminous intensity. These are the 7 basic SI units. Now we will see about the fundamental units and derived units. What is fundamental unit? The unit used to measure the fundamental quantities are called fundamental units. What is derived unit? The units which are used to measure the derived quantities, that are called derived units. Length is the extent of something between 2 points. The SI unit of length is meter. 1 meter is this. 1 meter is the distance traveled by light through vacuum in 1 by 29 crores 97 lakhs 92,458 seconds. Distance are of two types, larger distance and smaller distance. Larger distance, that is used to measure the distance of astronomical objects. In order to measure very large distance, we will use astronomical unit, light year and parsec. Now we will see about the astronomical unit. Astronomical unit is the mean distance of the center of the sun from the center of the earth. One astronomical unit, that is equal to 1.496 into 10 to the power 11 meter. The next one is light year. Light year is the distance traveled by light in 1 year in vacuum. One light year is the distance that light travels in a year. That is 9.46 into 10 power 15 meters. That is about 6 trillion miles. And the last one is parsec. What is parsec? The parsec is defined as the distance at which one astronomical unit that is perpendicular to the observer's line of sight subtends an angle of 1 arc. The parsec, a unit of length commonly used by the astronomers, that is equal to 3.26 light years. Kilometer, astronomical unit, large, light year, parsec, these are the larger units. Smaller units are used to measure small distances, such as distance between atoms in a molecule, size of the nucleus and wavelength. These are measured by smaller distance. These quantities are measured in angstrom unit. Fermi, angstrom, nanometer, micron, millimeter, centimeter, these are some of the smaller units. Next one is mass. What is mass? Mass is the quantity of matter that contain in a body. The SI unit of the body mass is kilogram. The unit grams and milligrams are the sub multiples of 1 by 10 part of the unit kilogram. 1 quintal, that is equal to 100 kilogram. 1 metric ton, that is equal to 1000 kilogram. 1 solar mass, that is equal to 2 into 10 power 30 kilogram. Atomic mass unit. Mass of a proton, neutron and electron that can be determined by determining using atomic mass unit. One atomic mass unit, that is equal to 1 by 12 part of the mass of carbon 12 atom. Next topic is time. Time is a measure of duration of events and the intervals between them. Temperature is the measure of hotness or coldness of the body. The SI unit of the temperature is Kelvin. The other units for measuring temperature are degree Celsius and Fahrenheit. Now we see about the unit prefixes. Unit prefixes are the symbols placed before the symbol of a unit that is used to specify the order of magnitude of the quantity that are useful to express very large and very small quantities. Kilo is a unit prefix in the unit kilometer. Here some of the unit prefixes were given. 10 power 24 iota, 10 power 21 zeta, 10 power 18 exo, 10 power 15 peta, 10 power 12 tetra, 10 power minus 1 deci, 10 power minus 2 centi, 10 power 21 septo, 10 power minus 24 yocto. These are the unit prefixes. Now we will see about the rules and conventions for writing SI units and their symbols. The units named after scientists were not written with a capital letter. For example, Newton, Henry, Ampere, and Watt. In these should be written in small letters only. Second one, the symbols of the units named after scientists should be written by the initial capital letters. For example, N for Newton, H for Henry, A for Ampere, and W for Watt. Small letters are used as symbols for units not derived from proper noun. For example, M for meter, kg for kilogram. Next one, fourth one, no full stop or other punctuation marks should be used within or at the end of the symbols. For example, 50m and a not as 50m. Fifth one, the symbols of the units are not expressed in plural form. For example, 10 kilogram, not as 10 kilograms. 10 kilogram is the correct one. When temperature is expressed in Kelvin, the degree sign is ohmmeter. Use of solid as is recommended for indicating the divisions of one unit symbol by other unit symbol. For example, meter per second or meter ms minus 1. The number and units should be separated by space. Accepted symbols alone should be used. For example, ampere should not be written as AMP, and the second should not be written as SEC. The numerical values of the physical quantities should be written in scientific form. Now the next topic is vernier caliper. In our daily life, we use meter scale for measuring length. They are calibrated in centimeter and millimeter. By using vernier caliper, we can have an accuracy of 0.1 millimeter. Now we will see about the description of the vernier caliper. The vernier caliper consists of long steel scale graduated in centimeter and millimeter, that is called main scale. To the left end of the main scale and upper end, a lower jaw are fixed perpendicular to the bar. These are named as fixed jaws. To the right of the fixed jaws, a slider with an upper and a lower movable jaw is fixed. The slider can be moved or fixed to any position using a screw. The vernier scale is marked on the slider and it moves along with the movable jaws and the slider. The lower jaws are used to measure the external dimensions. The upper jaws are used to measure the internal dimensions of the objects. The thin bar attached to the right side of the vernier scale is used to measure the depth of the hollow objects. Now we'll see about the usage of vernier caliper. The first step in using the vernier caliper is to find out its least count, range and zero error. What is least count? That means value of one smallest main scale division that is divided by total number of vernier scale division. Now we'll see about the zero error. How can we measure the zero error? Unscrew the slider and move it to the left such that both the jaws touch each other. There are two types of error, that is positive zero error and negative zero error. If the zero of the vernier shifts to the right of the main scale, it is called positive error. If it is shifted to the left of the zero of main scale, then that is called as negative zero error. Next one is the digital vernier caliper. Digital vernier caliper has digital display on the slider. It calculates and displays the measured values. The user need not manually calculate the least count, zero error, etc. Next one is the screw gauge. Screw gauge is an instrument that can measure the dimensional up to 1 divided by 100 of the millimeter or 0.01 millimeter. How can we measure the least count of the screw gauge? That is equal to value of one smallest pitch scale reading, that is divided by total number of head scale division. Zero error. When the mobile stud of the screw and opposite fixed stud on the frame area brought into contact, if the zero of the head scale coincides with the pitch scale axis, there is no zero error. Now we will see some of the measuring masses. First one is the common beam balance. A beam balance composed the sample mass with the standard references mass. This balance can be measured accurately up to 5 grams. Next one is the physical balance. Physical balance is used in labs and is similar to the beam balance, but it is a lot more sensitive. It can measure the mass of an object carried to the milligram. The standard references masses used in the physical balance are 10 milligram, 20 milligram, 50 milligram, 100 milligram, 200 milligram, 1 gram, 2 gram, 5 gram, 10 gram, 20 gram, 50 gram, 100 gram and 200 gram. The next one is digital balance. Nowadays for accurate measurements, digital balance are used, which measures mass accurately even up to the few milligrams, the least value being 100 milligram. This electrical device is easy to handle and commonly used in jewelry shops and labs also. The last one is the spring balance. This balance helps us to find the weight of an object. It consists of a spring fixed at one end and a hook attached to a rod at the other end. It works by Hooke's law. A pointer is attached to the rod, which slides over a graduated scale on the right. The spring extends according to the weight attached to the hook, and the pointer reads the weight of the object on the scale. Now we will see about the differences between mass and weight. Mass is a fundamental quantity, but the weight is the derived quantity. Mass has magnitude alone, that is a scalar quantity. Weight has a magnitude and direction, that is a vector quantity. Mass is the amount of matter contained in a body, but weight is the normal force exerted by the surface on the object against gravitational pull. Mass remains the same everywhere, but the weight varies from place to place. Mass is measured using physical balance, but weight is measured using spring balance. Mass unit is kilogram, but the weight unit is Newton. Now we will see the last topic, accuracy in measurements. When measuring physical quantities, accuracy is important. It is also important in our daily life also. You might have seen in jewelry shop how accurately they measured gold. What will happen if little more salt is added to food while cooking? So it is important to be accurate when taking measurement. Thank you, students.